Rat and Mole, far away, were still continuing their search.
Moley! Moley, where are you going? Moley! Mole, I am cold and I'm tired and I'm going home. I've finished with Toad. The riverbank's this way. Come on.
He turned and stumped off towards the river. But the mole, instead of following his friend, sat sadly down on a tree stump and began to cry.
Mole? What is it, old fellow? Whatever can be the matter?
I know it's a shabby, dingy little place. Not like your cozy quarters, or Badger's, or Toad's beautiful hall. But it was my own little home, and I went away and forgot all about it. And then I smelt it, and I wanted it. But you wouldn't stop, Ratty, and... Oh, dear, oh, dear. I had to leave it, and I thought my heart would break. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
I see it all now. What a pig I've been. Well, come on, old fellow.
Wherever you... going to, Ratty?
We are going to find that old home of yours, so you'd better come along. We shall need your nose.
But Mole had been away a long time. Mole End was dank and cold, and Mole was ashamed of his old home.
Oh, Ratty, why ever did I do it? Why did I bring you to this poor, cold little place? You might have been a riverbank by now, toasting your toes before a blazing fire.
Hang, riverbank. What a capital little house this is. So compact. Well, we'll make a jolly night of it, Moley. Now, the first thing we want is a good fire.
Oh, Rat, how about your supper? I've nothing to give you, not a crumb.
Oh, look, nothing to eat? Well, I mean, this is fit for a king. Now come with me and forage.
There's the carol singers. They come here every year. And I've nothing to give them either.
What a fellow you are for giving in, Mole. I distinctly saw a sardine tin opener, so there must be sardines at least. Well sung, boys.
Now come and have something to eat and drink. Absent friends, Badger and Toad, wherever he may be.
Excuse me, sir, but haven't you heard?
Heard what? And don't drop your H's.
About Mr. Toad, sir.
What about him?
Well, sir, he's got himself arrested.
Oh, my goodness.
To my mind, the only difficulty in this very clear case is how to make it sufficiently hot for the incorrigible rogue and hardened ruffian whom we see cowering in the dock before us. He has been found guilty on the clearest evidence. First, of stealing a valuable motor car. Secondly, of driving to the public danger. And thirdly, of gross impertinence to the rural police. Mr. Clark, what is the very stiffest penalty we can impose for each of these offences without, of course, giving the prisoner the benefit of any doubt? Because there isn't any.
Well, ma'am, you might give 12 months for the theft.
Which is mild.
And 3 years for furious driving.
Which is lenient.
and 15 years for the cheek, which was pretty bad sort of cheek. That adds up to...
19 years!
19 years?
And another year for being green! 20 years!
I've been told you are a criminal of deepest guilt and matchless artfulness and resource. So you will languish for 20 years in a deepest dungeon, in a best guarded jail, in a length and breadth of Merry England.
Badger. Mooley. Ratty. Where are you now?
The three friends were in conference at Toad Hall.
That's agreed, then. While Toad is incarcerated, we must not leave Toad Hall unprotected. I shall take charge of it. I owe it to his father.
Oh, no. Cheer up, Toad. Sit up and dry your eyes and be a sensible animal. Father says you haven't had a bite to eat for days. Yeah.
No. Take it away.
I've brought you something I've made myself. It's Bubble and Squeak.
Bubble and Squeak?
It's piping hot. That's better.
I don't know when I've had better Bubble and Squeak, even at Toad Hall.
Is that where you live?
Oh, the finest gentleman's residence in England. Oh, splendid architecture, superbly furnished. Oh, the most elegant china, valuable silver, tapestries, works of art. Oh, stained glass windows.
Through those windows, narrow, evil faces peered in silently at Badger as he sat guarding Toad's ancestral home. There were scufflings in the night. There were snorts and sniggers. There were creaking hinges and a groaning floorboard. Badger, suddenly aware, half turned where he sat. But a weasel cudgel sent him sprawling to the floor. They dragged him outside. They dumped him in the snow. Then closed the doors on that great, still body.
And my jokes. Who's so witty?
Toad. I have an aunt who's a washerwoman.
Oh, there, there, never mind. I have several aunts who ought to be washerwomen.
Toad, do be quiet. My Aunt Maud does all the washing in the jail. People are used to her coming in and out, and you're very much like her in build.
I am not. I have a very elegant figure for what I am.
So is my aunt for what she is. Here, try it on.
You're not suggesting that I should disguise myself as a washerwoman.
You're a horrid, proud, ungrateful animal when I'm trying to help you escape. I thought it was a shame you were shut up here for so long when you never hurt anyone or did any real harm. But have it your own way. You can stay here forever for all I care.
There, there. You are a good, kind, clever girl. And I am indeed a proud and stupid Toad.
Oh.
A few minutes later, Toad, in the washerwoman's clothes, was sweeping boldly past the jailer at his gloomy post.
Night, Maud.
Good night, old chap.
Old chap? Maud?
As Toad slipped through the prison gates,
nightmare.
The sounds of pursuit began behind him.
Ring the bell!
He looked this way and that, not knowing what to do.
Quick,
then he heard the sound of a distant train whistle and ran, panting, towards the station, where to his great relief he found a waiting engine and a friendly driver.
Hello, Mother.
Oh, sir. I am a poor, unhappy washerwoman, and I've lost all my money, and I must get home tonight. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
All right. That's against company regulations, but up you come.
In the nick of time, the engine pulled away.
Stop him!
Did another fox steal my car?
Widgie!
The world's hell-great heroes, as history books have shown, but never a name went down to fame compared with that of Toad.
Now, a second engine, loaded with pursuers, was steaming after the first.
The clever men at Oxford know all that's to be known, but none of them know half as much as intelligent Mr. Toad.
70!
Driver put on speed. The pursuers yelled, and their engine, too, threw out more smoke and steam.
The animals set in the ark, the tears in torrents flow. Who was it says there's land ahead, encouraging Mr. Toad? Encouraging Mr. Toad!
Oh, dear, kind Mr. Engine Driver. I am not really a washerwoman.
No, I'm a poor, unfortunate toad pursued by the law.
What did you do?
I only borrowed a motor car.
I don't hold with motor cars, and I don't hold with being ordered about on my own engine. Go on, hop off.
The driver braked. Toad jumped down. And as both engines whistled away into the night, he set off home, still singing.
The queen and all her ladies, they by the window sewed.
She cried, look who's that handsome man, they answered.
Mr. Toad.
Don't you know me, Ratty? It's me, Toad.
Toad?
Oh, Ratty, such trials and tribulations, so nobly born. Such escapes, such subterfuges, all so clever. I am a smart toad and no mistake.
Toady!
Hello, Mole. Wait till I tell you all about my adventures.
Toad, stop boasting and swaggering and behave yourself. You look like a washerwoman.
Hmm? Ah, I'll tell you about that. But first, if you'll give me a little light dinner, perhaps a glass of claret, and then I'll stroll up to Toad Hall and get a change of clothes.
Oh, Toady, you haven't heard.
Hmm? Heard? Heard what?
The weasels have taken Toad Hall.
Taken Toad Hall? What were my friends doing while I was lying helpless in my dungeon? I thought at least you and Mole and Badger...
Don't talk about Badger.
You don't mean...
They were too strong, even for Badger.
Oh, 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 noble Badger. Best of friends, eloquent, kind-hearted, faithful...
Now then, Toad, that's enough.
Badger!
Glad you're back. While Rat and Mole have been looking after me so kindly, I've been thinking about Toad Hall.
I shall never see my dear old home again. It's lost. Lost forever.
Lost nonsense. I have a plan.
Ooh.
The very next day, the friends met in Council of War in Rat's home by the river. All except Mole, that is, who had gone out early. Badger, now recovered from his experiences at Toad Hall, bent over his plans.
By 9 o'clock, the banquet should be in full swing.
So we should be in the secret tunnel by...
Ooh! Is there a secret tunnel?
Your father, a worthy animal, confided in me... But he said that only in the direst need should I inform you of it.
Oh, I know. It's that squeaky board in the butler's pantry.
Not at all.
Don't interrupt us, Toady. There's a good fellow. Now, about weapons. Pistols, of course.
My old blunderbuss is rather heavy, but we might be glad of it.
Depends how many sentries are on duty outside.
I say, you fellows, I've had such a time!
Mole was dressed in the very same washerwoman's clothes that Toad had escaped in.
Where have you been, Mole?
Why, to Toad Hall, of course. I marched up there as bold as brass. Good morning, gentlemen, says I to the sentries, very respectful. Want any washing done? And the sergeant, he said to me, run away, my good woman, run away. Run away, says I. It won't be me that'll be running away a short time from now. You're going to be attacked. 100 bloodthirsty badgers, I said, are going to attack Toad Hall with 6 boatloads of rats armed to the teeth and a picked body of toads known as the Diehards or Death or Glory Toads will storm the orchard, yelling for vengeance. There won't be much left of you to wash, I says, by the time they've done with you.
Oh, Mole, you silly ass. You've ruined the surprise. You've been and spoiled everything.
But Toad, surely Badger told you...
Mole, you have done well. I am exceedingly pleased with you.
But
now, all depends upon tonight.
When darkness fell, Badger, Mole, Rat and Toad slipped out across the fields.
The entrance to the tunnel is along here.
Oh, that tunnel!
But as they started along the tunnel, Toad was incorrigible.
When the Toad came home, there was panic in the parlour and howling in the hall. There was crying in the cowshed and shrieking in the store. When the Toad came home, when the Toad came home. When the Toad came home, there was smashing in of window and crashing in of door. There was chivying of weasels that fainted on the floor. When the Toad came home, when the Toad came home. Bang!
Go the drums.
Trumpeters are tooting, and the soldiers are saluting, and the cannon they are shooting, and the motor cars are hooting. When the Toad came home, when the Toad came home.
At last, the friends stood behind a secret door that opened onto the minstrels' gallery. Below them, a hall full of weasels cheering their chief.
I say, they are going.
And now a toast to our kind host, Mr. Toad. The toast is down with Toad.
I'll give him down with Toad and in my own banqueting hall too.
Toad rushed through the opening, saw the weasels, paused, his mouth agape, and rushed back again.
I think we'd better wait for the others.
Others?
The 100 badgers and all those rats and the death or glory toads. We could do with a few more moles as well. Where are the others?
There are no others, Toad.
No others?
No, Toad. It's just Badger, Rat, me, and you, Toad.
But thanks to our young friend Mole, they think there are hundreds of us. Come on.
Always a Toad!
Toad let out his battle cry and somehow found himself hanging from his own chandelier. At last, only the chief weasel himself could hold out against the assault. It was just then that Toad let go and landed slap on top of him. And that was that.
Well done, Toad.
Oh, Badger, I didn't do anything. You fellows did it all. I was... Hooray for... Hooray for us! Hooray!
The weasel flag came down from the Toad Hall flagpole, and Toad's flag went up in its place. After a few days tidying up, it seemed to Toad as though the weasels had never been there. His friends, too, returned to their quiet lives, and one springtime afternoon gathered together at Ratty's house. Badger sketched the river scene as Rat sat in his boat on his beloved river, while Mole was painting again, painting a mooring post.
Did I tell you Toad said he might be dropping in for tea?
He's quite a reformed character, more like his esteemed father every day. We may indeed congratulate ourselves.
Still... It was rather exciting, wasn't it? I'm almost sorry it's all over.
Oh! You maniac! Walk him off! He's gone too far!
Toad was back.
Hello, you fellows!
Not in a car, but in a flying machine. The others turned, looked at one another, and sighed, and smiled. And the river, and the river bankers, and Toad, went on about their business just as they always had, and always would.
The wind in the willows sang song. Stories unfold. Willows, the tales you have told me. When in the willows you just seem to know who you can turn to and which way to go to unwind. We Yeah.